Good morning. Today we're going to start our discussion, our first laboratory activity in business analysis tools. So in this topic, we're going to use or we're going to explore the basic functionalities of Excel. Okay, so let's start. So when you are in the Google Classroom, so this is how it looks like. So just go to the chapter 1, a preview of business statistics, and then you go to introduction. This is the introduction for the lecture part. So, but what we are going to do here, our concern here is for the laboratory exercises. So this is the laboratory exercise. So what we're going to do is just to click this one. This is the raw data. This is the raw data. And then this is the document file. This is the Word file. You're going to attach all your answers in the document file. So first is you're going to click this one, right click, and then you can click open new tab. And then you can right click this one and then open in a new tab. Okay, so to download, just click this one here. You have to download all your personal files, and then you can save a personal copy in your Google, in your drive, your network drive. Okay, so download this one. And then we can also download the doc file. Okay, another reminder, guys, when you submit your document, you have to submit your document. You have to save this document in a PDF format. You have to submit this one in a PDF format because the PDF, the pictures or any graphics that you're going to attach there will not be distorted. Okay? So I'm going to show you how we're going to convert the doc file into PDF later on. So let's start. So just click this one, tabs. Okay, so let's now explore the basic. So if you're going to, if there's a prompt here, the protected view, enable editing. Okay, so let's explore the tab first. This is the home tab. This is the insert. So if you want to insert graph later in our activities, so in the future activities, we're going to go with here. Then if we want to change the layout of the document size, we're going to explore here later. And then the formula, special formulas here, and then the data. Okay. Then the review, and then the view, help, and the Acrobat. This is just Acrobat is a special extension add-in that I used personally. Okay, so in this particular case here, we're only going to explore the basic, and then we will explore the later, the more advanced topics in the next activities. So first is we want to change the font style. So if you write something here, let's say your name here is Louis Guerra. Okay, so that's bold. Okay, so let's try to put here Louis Guerra. Okay, and then you want to change the font style. So just go here, Calibre, and then just use the font style. Let's say the most commonly used is the Times New Roman. Okay, so that. And then you want to change the font size. So the size you can adjust here. Let's say the 12, and then, or you can, let's say 48. But you can also do this in order to slowly increase the size. You can click this one. If you want to increase the size, slowly decrease the size. Now guys, I will set it to 12. And then let's say bold. So to change this one to bold, click this one. Make sure to click the cell. Click the cell and then you press the bold. That's the bold sign. And then italic. This is the italic. And then if you want to underline this one, so that's the underline. So you can adjust the column here. Okay. And the next is if you want to put a box. If you want to put a box, this is a common methods or common steps that you're going to repeatedly use later on in our future activities. So we have to be very familiar with these tools, and then we will have a special quiz on how we're going to do the simple commands in Excel. Okay, so let's try. Let's say we'll do business analysis tool. Okay, and then you wanted to box all of these. So just explore here and then find all outside box. You can also select Control Z for undo. You can also choose this one if you wanted only to have the bottom border, or if you wanted to have only the, let's say, the double bottom border, so something like that. Okay, just explore the other tabs later on. Next is you want to fill color. So if you want to fill this one is color, let's apply this one here. You want to fill this one in color, let's say color blue. Okay, that's like blue. And then we want to change the font color. So for example, if we're going to change this one into dark color, let's say the dark blue, and then we wanted to change the font color, for example, the product name, the quantity, the unit price without tax and with tax, to white. So you just click this one here and then change to white. Simple as that. Okay. So guys, we are only reviewing here the basics in order for us to have a common baseline. Okay. In order to avoid the assumptions that every one of us knows Excel. Okay. So if we want to change the alignment, for example, this is a very common. So in this particular case here, the business analysis tool, the alignment is on the left side. So if you want to change this one into center, just go here. This is the left, this is the center, and that is the right. Okay, so we want to make it in the center. Okay, next is we have to merge columns. In this part of cells. So in this particular case here, for example, you need all of this column of the cells here. You highlight the cells that you want to merge, and then you can simply click the merge center. Okay, and then it will automatically merge the cells, and then the alignment is the center alignment. Okay, so you can type here your name. So if you want that the alignment will be on the left side, so you can simply click the left, right, and then center. And then if you want to box all the borders, all borders. Okay, as simple as that. Next is we want to explore the currency. This is very important. For example, in this particular case here, if we wanted that our unit price is in pesos, so we will not change it here. Let's say 5 pesos. This is 5. Then we want to change the format, the unit of 5 into pesos. Just click this one and then go to the currency. And then click pesos. So that is automatically 5 pesos. If you want to change it back to the original decimal point, so just click this portion here. Okay? And then in this particular case here, there are 2 zeros. So if you want to increase the number of decimal points, just manipulate it using this one here. Increase, and then you can decrease the decimal points. Okay, let's put some 1 decimal point. Okay, and the next, the basic addition. So the basic addition now is, let's say, so if we want to do a simple calculation in Excel, you have to start with an equal sign. So in this particular case here, equals, and then let's say 1 plus 1, then equals, automatically it will give you an answer. However, if you will not start by pressing the equals, so let's say 1 plus 1, it will just simply copy the what you have written. So make sure to start with an equal sign. Okay, that is the simple 1 plus 1. So in this particular case here, the next example is, what if you wanted to add these values here? For example, we have some values here. 1, 2, 3. And then by the way guys, another reminder, in Excel, if the Excel will automatically copy the algorithm that you are going to, or the sequence, or the pattern that you establish. For example, in this particular case here, 1, 2, and 3. So the value increments by 1. So if you highlight this one and then you copy all of that, so the Excel will automatically follow that algorithm or that pattern. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so as simple as that. So let's say the simple addition. So there is a one method, equals, you start always the calculation with equal sign. Equals, and then let's say let's add this one, 1, and then you press the plus sign in your keyboard, plus, and then 2, plus, 2, plus, 2, plus, 2, plus, 2, and then just simply press equals. Okay, 28. Okay, so there is another method if we will use the function method. So the function method is the easiest part. So in this particular case here, equals. So let's say we have to use the sum function, and then you highlight all of these. So ulitin natin. So equals, and then you write the sum. And then you highlight all the cells that you want to get the sum value. So highlight mo yan, then simply press enter. Okay, so the same result, the answer is 28. So the next is do the basic subtraction. So the basic subtraction is, you simply do this one, equals, let's say we want to subtract 7 minus, let's say, the 3 here. Then just simply press equals. Okay, another example, equals, let's say we want to subtract the value of this particular cell minus the value of this particular cell. So just press equals. Then the result is negative 1. Next is if you want to do multiplication. So if you want to do multiplication, there are two ways. So you press this one, equals, and then the 6 here, and then in your keyboard you find this symbol here, the asterisk, and then just click the another cell that you want to solve the product. So in this particular here, you want to multiply 6 and 7, just press enter in your keyboard. Okay, another method is you start with equals, and then you open close parentheses. This is very important. The parentheses is very important if we are going to combine the operations, the plus and minus. So you can also do this. Highlight that one, close parentheses, and then close parentheses. Yeah, and then we close this one. So the result, oh yeah, reference. What happened? Sabi niya. So that we have an error. So sa tingin ko, ayaw niya. You really have to put an address here. So let's try to do a calculation with a combination of the plus and the negative. So let's try this value here. So equals, we want to this one plus this value here, close parentheses, and then we want it to multiply with the value here, let's say 7, then just press equals. Okay, the result is 21. Okay, so now let's try to do the activity that we have. So to delete all of these values here, the necessary values, delete all of that, and then right click and then simply delete. Okay, so let's go back to the Word file, to this Word file here. Okay, just click the Word file, and then let's try to do the activity. So enable editing. So first, what is the total transaction price without tax? So in this particular Excel file here, ito yung ginawa natin. So this is the product. This is an, I think, the, yeah, sales. And we're going to do the sales report here. So for example, we have the products, product number, or the product name, product 2, product 5. And then in the particular transaction, ilang quantity yung pinorchase, and then what is the total, what is the unit price of the particular product. So for example, the product 2, the cost of that product is 16,756. Okay, so let's try to do this. Okay, so don't you worry guys with respect to the different values here. So for example here, the product 2, the price is, let's say, 16,000. And then pagdating dito, the price is this one. This is just a random data that I made. So but what we are doing here is simply a simple calculation to do how Excel works in this kind of problem. So without tax, so you simply multiply the quantity with the unit price of the particular product name. So equals, and then the quantity, how many quantity did that particular transaction had. So equals, so we're going to multiply this one times, and then yeah. Okay, we can also do this again, equals 5, multiply to this one, and then press enter. Okay, so take note guys, in this particular case here, the algorithm is very simple. We have to multiply this portion here with the value here. So using these two here, the formula bar in our formula, we can simply drag this one, click on the cell, or just to make sure you highlight all these two here. In order for the, we're telling the Excel to do the algorithm based on this on these formulas here. So you highlight, you can also this only this one, okay, and then you go to this square here, small square, make sure that your cursor will change into cross, and then just simply click that, and then you hold your cursor and then you drag it down. Okay, so as what you can see now, the values will solve by itself. Let's check. So let's say this value here. So equals 6 times this value here. Okay, so as simple as that. So let's now try. But this is the first question. So the first question is, what is the total transaction price? So transaction price without tax. So without tax, we have to add all of this value here. So if you're going to do the manual work, it is very, very tedious task. So what we're going to do here is we have to maximize the use of our Excel. So you highlight all of that, and then let's put some value, some border here. Then let's label it total, and then we have to add all of this value here. So instead of using the equals and then we plus all of these values in this particular cells, we can simply use the sum function, and then tab, click na then equals, you write this sum, and then just press on your keyboard tab, or yeah, you can simply click this one here, double click, and then you highlight from this value here up to the last part. Yeah, and then simply press enter. So that is the value without tax. So in the next column here, without tax, so we have to compute first the tax for this particular, we have to minus the tax here. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we have to get the, we have to less the value here by 5%. Okay? Kasi we wanted to get the profit, we have to remove the tax. So, if we will remove the 5%, that is automatically 95%. Or, okay? So, that is 1 minus equals 1 minus the 5%, that is 0.05. So, that is 0.95. So, what we wanted to do here is we want to get the 0.95 here. Okay? Or you can simply use the absolute reference here. Kasi if we wanted to, so if we are going to do that, equals this value here times 0.95, that is very easy. You can also drag all of these. However, if you are going to change the value of the tax here, let's say we wanted to change that one to 6%, you have to recompute it all over again. So what we wanted to do here is, we wanted to solve these values here. If we try to solve to change the value of the tax here, it will automatically update. So what we are going to do is we are going to do some equation. So equals, let's say how we are going to do that, equals this value here times open close parenthesis 1 minus, let's say 6% here, then equals. Yeah, and then if we want to compare that one, equals, right, this is already the 5%. Let's go back to the 5%. So if we are going to solve the 5% in our previous example, equals this value here times 0.95. Let's compare the value, very, very the same. So this is the formula now. This is D5. If you click this, the formula bar, this value here, the D5 times multiplied by 1 minus the tax here. However, so if we're going to drag all of this, it will generate wrong values. Why? Because if you're going to drag this one, this value, the C3 here, this original C2, this C2 should be based on this value here. So if we drag all of these, this red box here will also move by this one. And then this portion here will move this one. Right, let's click. So if we're going to drag this one, so the value, the syntax or the algorithm for this particular cell will be carried to this one. So this blue here will be here, and then this one will be here. So let's check. So, right. So this, the to get the value here, this value here times 1 minus C3. Kasi the Excel is just simply following the algorithm that we set. So in this particular case, what we wanted to do here is, for this value here, even though if we drag all of this, we wanted to have the C2 to remain here. Okay? We wanted this C2, we call that one in Excel as absolute referencing. Okay, absolute referencing, kasi even though if we drag all of this, we are telling Excel that do not move this particular cell. This is an absolute reference. So how are we going to do that? So to do the absolute reference, you have to add dollars here and then dollars here. Okay, the other way, the simplest way is you press F4. Okay, F4 in your keyboard. So for example, that is C2 again, C2. Okay, and then anywhere in the C2, just press F4 in your keyboard, and then it will automatically add dollar sign in the particular cell. So let's try equals, and then if you're going to drag this small square here, we're telling the Excel that copy the syntax here, this value here times 1 minus the absolute reference of this particular cell here. So let's try to move. Okay, so let's check the formula. So this value here times 1, and then this particular cell will not move. The value will only move in this particular cell. So we already verified. So you can simply drag all of that. Okay, so it looks good. So what we're going to do now is we're going to get the sum. Okay, so equals the sum, and then we highlight all of this. And then just press enter. So it destroyed the template, so let's get this one and then let's put some border at the bottom. Okay, so that's it. So let's check if the result of the with tax and with tax and the without tax will coincide with our checking. So we have to get the what's the percentage here. Our tax rate is 5%. So if we're going to reduce, if we're going to subtract 5% in this value here, it should come up with this value here. So that is equals 89, this value times 0.9518517. So good. Okay, so check. So let's try to change the value of our tax here. Let's say we're going to change it to 10%. Okay, so as simple as that, it changes this value here. Okay, so another thing that this is very important is to do a conditional formatting. Okay, so if you want to highlight a certain cell which follows the certain condition, so we can do the conditional formatting. So for example, if we wanted to highlight the values, let's say the values greater than 1 million. If we're going to do that, you go to the conditional formatting and then we'd say highlight. We can also explore all of these later in the later chapters, but we will only do the highlight cells, let's say, if greater than. So if greater than, let's say 1 million, 1 million, 2, 3, 1 million, and then we can change this one to green. Okay, we can also do that. Okay, so we can already easily see the values with greater than 1 million. And another way is, let's say, let's highlight less than 100,000. Yeah, let's highlight. So conditional formatting, highlight rules, say less than. So less than 100,000. Okay, then press OK. You can also simply, you can also explore some additional conditional formatting here. Okay, let's say for example, equal to or in between. Okay, so you have to answer all of these. I already changed this one, and that was the total, and then you have to answer all of that. And then for example, if you already answered that one, how are we going to save this one into PDF? So you go to the file and then save as, and then you browse, let's say browse, and then make sure, guys, this is just a suggestion in your part. Make sure to save all your data in the drive, in the network drive, so that whenever, wherever, whatever computer that you are going to use, you're going to have an access on your previous files. So new, and then let's say dot files, and then just change the save as type to PDF, and then just save. Then this is already the PDF file. Make sure, guys, make sure to submit the final paper in PDF format. Okay, so good luck, and if you have some questions or clarification, please comment down below, or we can discuss this one during the class. So good luck and God bless.